Nighttime Series Analysis and Forecasting tutorial. My name is Juan D'Amico, I'm an economist, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to import a dataset in R, how to define our dataset as a time series object, and then we're going to plot the series. That's the idea for this first tutorial. So the hope is that after this tutorial we can start building on more and more and more modules, all right? So the idea is that we're going to be able to do some ARIMA models, some bar models, vector error correction models, and other models that you guys may ask. So let's get started with today's tutorial. Recall the idea of this tutorial is for beginners, so I'm assuming you guys are not very familiar with R. So far, in my first tutorial, I have shown you how to install the software. So in this second tutorial, what we are going to do is to import the dataset. The first thing that we're going to do is go into File, and we're going to get a new script. This script is like instead a do file. We're going to be basically keeping track of all our codes. So once we are done, all we have to do is click on Run, and we're going to execute our code. We're going to put a title using here this symbol, and you can write any title. The first one is going to be set a working directory, and the idea of setting a working directory is that we are going to define where all our objects, all our outputs, all our graphs, all our codes, all everything, guys, everything saves. So in order to do that, what we are going to do is we're going to go into these three dots in here. So we're going to manually select, okay, in which folder we want to have that. In this particular case, I have it. This folder is called Tutorial 1. I'm going to select this. And inside this folder, something you should do as well is include all the data sets that you guys want to work with. For today, I have a data set that is made out of two variables. One is oil prices and the real economic activity, that it's basically an index built by Lutz Killian. So going to my website, you can download this data set so we can start working on this together. I'm going to click on open, and you can see, as I mentioned before, this folder that was in my desktop, I put in the data set. So that's what we're going to use. The next thing that we need to do is to set this as a working directory. So to do that, all we're going to do is to click here where it says more, and we're going to set as a working directory. And you can see that in the console, here is showing us what's the command for this. So I'm gonna copy this, and I'm gonna keep it here for the future. If I ever need to set again the working directory, that's what we got, that's how we're going to do it. The next thing that we're going to do is to install certain packages that we're going to need in order to be able to import the data. This particular case, what we have is an Excel file. So the library that you need, I'm gonna call here a title, install libraries. And the library that we need is install packages, and we're open parentheses, and in quotation, we're gonna type readxl. This what's going to do is to install the packages that we need. You can go in here where it says packages. You can look with this magnifying glass. We can look for readxl. You can see that I already have this installed, so I don't need to run this line of code. But if you don't have it, you'll definitely need to run this code. The next thing that we're going to do is to load the library. One thing is installing the library. Now we have it installed, but we need to load this library. Load the library, and all you have to do is type library, open parentheses, and you're gonna type the name of that library. It's readxl. Perfect. The next thing, we're going to import the dataset. So import the dataset. All we're going to do is to create an object. In this particular case, this is the way you create objects. Any given name, you can put it dataset, data, whatever you would like to name it. And you need these two, basically these two symbols here. After those two symbols, you are basically assigning something to this object, in this particular case to dataset. And the line is, we're going to read an Excel file, and we're asking ourselves, okay, which Excel file do we want to read? So I'm going to open parentheses. Any sort of text in this particular case goes with quotation marks. So we go with the name of our file is called oil data. We put the extension. And just to make sure, this is an Excel file. So just to make sure, we're going to specify in which Excel sheet we've got our data. Okay, so as simple as that, we have already imported our dataset. Something that I want to show you is how to view our dataset. So view our dataset, and we can just call head dataset, and this is going to show the first six rows of our dataset. So let's run this command. We're going to load the I'm not going to run install package because I already have it installed, but I'm going to run this. So let's run all this. And we can see I'm getting an error. It's telling me the path doesn't exist. But right away, I can tell I have a typo. Yes, because this is not the right extension. So make sure that we have the extensions written properly. So let me fix this. It's XLSX. Now this should work. Let's run these lines again. And perfect. Now we can see it's working. And in our console, we can see what is the outcome. Something I don't like is having this first column that's called observation date. I don't like this column at all because we're going to be working with time series data, and I want to create my own index, my own data set, my own time series object, sorry. So something we can do is we're going to go into the data set after this line. We're going to open a square bracket, and when we open square brackets, we are specifying to R which rows and columns we want to keep. So I'm not going to put anything in the first element because the first element is going to be rows, and I want to have all the rows of my data set. So I'm going to put a comma here, and what I want to remove is the first column. So it's a minus one. Remember, the first object in the syntax is going to be rows, the second one is columns. So we want to get rid of the first column. Let's run this. And now if we print again our data, we can see that we got rid of that first column. All right, so that's perfect. We got rid of the first column, but that's, we're not ready yet. What we need to do now is something I would like to do is to rename my variables. Something very important when we are working with models, guys, is to ensure that we keep easy titles, because then we can have, it's going to take a lot of time to code. We can have errors. We can have problems. Let's just keep easy names. So we're going to rename the columns. The way to do this is this command, which is call names. We have to specify for which object it's our data set. That's the way we have called our data, which, by the way, is right now in our environment. So what we need to do is we need to use this symbol. This is an object we're doing here. And we're going to put C, which is for, it's a vector, yes? Anytime we use in R, C, an open bracket is a vector. The first element, the first column, yes, we're going to call it oil. And the second column, we're going to call it, let's call it activity. Perfect. So that's the way we're going to name our variables. I'm going to run this line. It worked without any problems, and we can run again this line here, and we can see that it has changed the names. We see oil is the first column, activity is the second column. We're pretty much done, guys, for this first tutorial. I think we're doing great. So just a couple more lines and we're going to be done. The first thing we need to do now is we need to make these a time series object. So the idea, and also, sorry, this is quarterly frequency. Let's put here quarterly frequency. The idea is that we are letting R know that we're working with time series. So these are not just isolated numbers. We have a data set with two variables, two columns that contain time series objects. So we're going to put whatever title we want, TS data, whatever, doesn't really matter. This is up to you, but this is what matters. Is the code is TS. We're going to TS our data set. Yes, this is in our environment, the way we've called our data. What's the start date? Well, our data set with oil prices starts from, let me open here a vector. It's going to start in 1988. And it starts from the first, basically the first quarter, all right? We put a comma because we need to put one more thing in our code, and that's going to be the frequency. We could frequency equals, and we're gonna put 4. This is for quarterly data. Yes, we've got 4 quarters. So let's run this code now. Let's run it. That's perfect. Now we have here our time series. It's telling us that it goes from 1988 to 2025. Guys, everything is fantastic. Everything is perfect. We are almost ready for start with more complex tutorials, which is actually running time series models. So something we can do to conclude with this tutorial is to plot the series. The code for this, the command is plot. We need to tell what do we want to plot. In this particular case, we want to plot our data, our time series data. Let's say TS underscore data, comma. Something you can do is write everything. You don't need to hit here and enter, but I like to... It's easier when you code to put different parts of the syntax in different lines, because it's going to help us then. Let's suppose you want to change the title, the labels, whatever you want to change is going to be way easier to find. So for example, for the title of the graph, we're going to call it, for example, oil prices and activity index. That's going to be the title of our graph. The command is main, that's for the title, and it goes in quotation marks. Comma, the next line, we have the label for the x-axis, is xlab, it's simple as that. Remember, any text in quotation marks. Let's call it time. Now, let's put a comma, always goes a comma after each new element of our code. For the white labels, we're gonna call it values. You can call it whatever you want, of course. We're just playing around with this. And that's all, guys. That's as simple as that. Let's run these lines. And here we get the plot. So that's fantastic. Here we have the plot. Let me zoom this. We see the title, oil prices and activity index. We can see the name of our variables, oil and activity, which is perfect. And here we have time. So that's going to be all the content for today, guys. I hope you found this useful. It's the most important part of any project is to start working properly, setting up our data. I hope that this was useful. Please go into my website, www.forecastingeconomics.com. You're going to find all my tutorials. You're going to find the data set to replicate this tutorial. And please feel free to subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be submitting many more videos. Please give it a like, leave your comment. Everything helps me to keep growing my channel. You're part of this channel. We're all growing together. We're working on many applied time series projects. So guys, give it a like. Make sure you subscribe, share with your people, share with your network, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.